Now x of t is equal to a cos omega t plus theta, a cos omega t plus theta. So it is taking the value, t can take the value from minus infinity to the plus infinity. Minus infinity to the plus infinity is taking the value. So by observation, we can see that it's a periodic signal here. So for the periodic signal, directly we go for finding the power of the signal will go here. We'll go for finding the power of the signal. If you go for finding the energy of this signal, so the energy will become equal to infinity here. If you want, you can find out that one. So for this signal, let us find out the power here. It is being given a cos omega t plus theta. So here, the value for the a cos omega naught t, a cos omega naught t plus theta, let us take this as omega naught t. So the fundamental period omega is equal to, so it's a omega naught here, okay, the period, okay, t is equal to, so 2 pi divided by omega, 2 pi by omega, or else we can say that in place of omega, we have omega naught. So the fundamental period t is given by, so 2 pi divided by omega naught here, you can take by observation. By observation, the given signal is a periodic signal. You can take omega is equal to omega naught. So this is, you can call it as the angular frequency. We're going to call here angular frequency. We're going to call here. So you can take angular frequency omega is equal to the omega naught. So the fundamental period t is given by. Fundamental period t is equal to 2 pi by omega. T is equal to 2 pi by omega. In place of omega, we have omega naught here. So we are going to make this one. So it is equal to the t into omega naught will take. So this will become equal to the 2 pi will consider here. So t into omega naught is equal to 2 pi or omega naught, anyone you can take here. So this you are going to consider here. Call this as equation number one. We are going to make use of this one in future here. So right, then, okay, so we got the fundamental period we got here and we find equated this equation here. So now we know the average power of the periodic signal is given by, so you can take the average power of the periodic signal is given by, so it is integral from minus t by 2 to the plus t by 2, okay, x of t, the magnitude of the whole square into dt, in place of x of t, we can substitute this expression. So p is equal to 1 by t. The time interval, either we can take from minus t by 2 to the plus t by 2, or we can take from 0 to the t, you can take anything you can take. So both is having the same thing. Okay, so x of t is nothing but it will become a square cos square omega naught t plus theta, where theta is nothing but the, it's a phase shift here. So here the value theta, which is nothing but already we know this one. So theta is nothing but the, it's a phase shift here. Okay. So let us substitute. A square we have substituted here. And also we know that we know the formula. So the formula is nothing but cos 2 theta formula. You know already we are familiar with this one. So cos 2 theta is nothing but 2 cos squared theta. Minus 1 here. So let us, so this is in the form of cos square theta. Let us solve for that one. So cos square theta. So this is equal to send here. So it has become 1 plus cos 2 theta divided by 2. 1 plus cos 2 theta divided by 2 here. Okay. So in place of theta, we have omega naught t. Let us substitute the formula. So P is equal to 1 over T. Okay. So minus T by 2 to the plus T by 2. A square is a constant. Let us take constant outside the integral. Cos square omega naught T, we can substitute as 1 plus. Okay. You want 2 also, you can take it as a common. This is a 2 we'll get here. So first let us substitute here. Later we'll take common. So 1 by 2 into cos 2 theta. In place of theta, we have this one omega naught T. Omega naught t plus theta, so it will become 2 omega naught t plus 2 theta will get here into dt. 2 omega naught t plus theta into did that one. Okay. Done. So done, right? Any doubts? Okay. Now we got this expression we got here. So this one we got P is equal to the A square. Okay. So now what we'll do is let us take two outside here. So just I'm going to write here. You can see here. So the power P is equal to A square divided by 2. I'm going to take outside. So 2t integral from minus t by 2 to the plus t by 2. So it is 1 plus cos 2 omega naught t plus 2 theta. Okay. So into dt a square divided by 2. So t by 2 to the minus t by 2, 1 plus cos 2 omega naught t plus 2 theta divided by 2 into dt here. So 2 I have taken outside here. Let us do integrate this one. The integration of 1 is nothing but t, and the integration of cos theta is nothing but, so it is sine theta into whatever the respective things you are going to get divided by the a here. For example, if I am having cos ax is there, the integration of cos ax is sin ax by a will get here. Sin ax by a. Okay. So sin ax by a will get here. Okay. So let us do that integration here. So the power p is equal to a squared divided by 2t. Okay. So the integration of 1 is nothing but it is t from minus t by 2 to the plus t by 2. Minus t by 2 to the plus t by 2. Okay. So next the integration of cos is nothing but it's a sine 2 omega naught t. The limit is from minus t by 2 to the plus t by 2 will get here. Minus t by 2 to the plus t by 2. Then minus t by 2 to the plus t by 2 will get here. So done now. You can see, right? Okay, p is equal to a square 2 a square divided by 2t. So this is the limits we got here. Taken, right? Okay, now let us apply the limits for the limits of the integration. Let us apply it here. So p is equal to a square divided by 2t. The integration of t is, so t by 2 to the minus of minus t by 2. Okay, so plus the integration of sine already, cos we are done here. So let us apply the limits here. Sine 2 omega naught in place of t. Let us substitute with the upper limit. T by 2 plus 2 theta will remain same here. Okay, so 2 omega naught t minus, I'm going to substitute the lower limit here. So minus sine 2 omega naught t by 2 minus t by 2, because it's a minus t by 2 plus 2 theta we're going to substitute here. Okay. Done, right? Okay, fine. So here 2 will get cancelled. So 2 will get cancelled here. Omega naught into t plus 2 theta, omega naught into t plus 2 theta is there. So let us find the sum of this one. T by 2 minus of minus will become plus t by 2. So it will become t will get here. So p is equal to a square divided by 2t into t. Okay, so into t plus. Okay. Next, the integration of this one. So this is the sum we have here. So sine. So this will become omega naught into t plus 2 theta minus sine. Okay, so omega naught into t plus 2 theta. So whole thing divided by 2 into omega naught will get here. Yes, any doubts? If any doubts, you can ask me. Sine omega naught t plus 2 theta minus sine omega naught t plus 2 theta divided by 2 into omega naught will get here. Okay, so done, right? Okay, so now what we'll do is what we'll do is, so sine omega naught t plus 2 theta is there. So we already substituted in the this one here. So t into omega naught is equal to 2 pi. We have substituted here. We got the fundamental period. So t into omega naught is equal to 2 pi. Let us substitute that one here. So omega naught into t is equal to, so you can take, we have omega naught into t is equal to the 2 pi. Let us do substitute that one. Here also let us do substitute here. Okay. Let us do substitute that one. So p is equal to a square divided by 2t. Okay. So t we got from this one. So this has become sine 2 pi plus 2 theta minus sine, okay, 2 pi plus 2 theta whole thing divided by 2 omega naught. 2 omega naught.
Plus alva sir.
Yeah,
sir, minus 2 omega t
birthday. Yeah, minus 2.
Minus.
Yeah, so minus is there. Minus. So this is minus only. This is minus only because this is still minus 2 pi plus 2 theta is there here. Minus 2 pi plus 2 theta is there. So it will be considered as minus 2 pi only. Okay, it is plus agadilla. Okay, now. So suppose if 2 theta is not there, so sine of minus theta can be taken as a plus minus sine theta we could have taken here. Okay. So now already we know that 2 pi is nothing but 360 here. So enough 2 pi plus theta, it is being considered as a, okay, sine of 2 pi plus theta can be considered as a sine theta only because sine of 360 plus theta is equal to sine theta only here. Okay, so you can take, so we know that sine of 2 pi plus theta is equal to sine theta. Sine 2 pi plus theta is equal to sine theta. We can do substitute here. Here also sine of 360 minus theta. Okay. So sine of 2t minus 2 pi is also equal to the sine 2 pi only. Sine 2 theta only will get here. This is equal to the sine 2 theta only will get here. Sine 2 theta only. Okay. Let us do substitute here. So this will become sine 2 theta. This will become another sine 2 theta here. Okay, so both the sine theta will get cancelled. The remaining thing will be the t will get here. Okay, so taken right. Taken no. So we know that sine 2 pi plus 2 theta is equal to sine theta. Sine 2 theta minus 2 pi is also equal to the sine 2 theta. Okay, so I will turn the page back. Okay, so this will become equal to the, so the average power P is equal to the, we have this one. Okay, so we have this one. So A squared divided by 2T plus T. I'm going to write the same thing here. P is equal to A squared divided by 2T. So this is T plus sine theta minus sine theta, so sine 2 theta, sorry, sine 2 theta minus sine 2 theta divided by, so 2 omega naught here, so this will get cancelled with this one, so p is equal to a square divided by 2 pi into t. Okay, so already t is there here, so you can see that t is there here, so this is not 2 pi, this is t here. So TT will get cancelled. So the average power is equal to the A squared 2 by 2 watts here. The average power of the this periodic signal is equal to A squared divided by 2 watts here. Okay, so this is the average power of the periodic signal here. Okay. Then any doubts? Any doubts? So I repeat the things what I have done so far. So you've taken the problem of finding the average power of the periodic signal here. Average power of the periodic signal. Okay, so here we are taken the a cos omega naught t plus 2 theta we are taken here. So by observation, we can see that this is a periodic signal here. By observation, this is nothing but the periodic signal. Okay, so here omega is equal to omega naught. So t is equal to 2 pi by omega we are taken here. This is the fundamental period. So it is t into omega naught is equal to 2 pi here. Okay, we have substituted, you have taken the formula for the periodic signal. So 1 by t into, so integral from minus t by 2 to plus t by t x of p the whole square into dt. So theta is the phase shift here in this given problem. Okay, so right, so we have substituted the value of the x of t here. We have substituted the value of x of t. P is equal to 1 by t minus t by 2 to this one. So we have substituted by taking the square here. And we know that cos 2 theta is equal to 2 cos square theta minus 1. So cos square theta is equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta divided by 2. So here in place of theta, we can substitute omega naught t plus theta here. So if you're getting confused, just you can take some other something pi we can take here. Okay, so don't get confused. Theta is here, theta is here. We can cancel like this. Don't do that one. So just for I'm substituting in the generalized formula here. Okay, so after substituting, one plus cos 2 omega naught t plus t. So we integrated the things here. So after integrating, we got the integration of 1 is nothing but t we got here, and integration of cos is nothing but so sine ax by a we got here. Okay, so we integrated, substituted limits, and we substituted omega naught t is equal to the t 2 pi here. So sine of 360 plus theta, 360 minus theta is equal to sine theta only. We got here and we cancelled each other and we got the average power of the periodic signal. It is equal to the a square by 2 we got here. Average power of the periodic signal is equal to the a square by 2 we got here. Okay, so done this. Any doubts in this one? This is the exam problem. So plenty of times this problem has been asked in the exam here. So this will be asked for 6 to 8 marks. They will ask here, 6 to 8 marks. Okay. Then take this problem. Find the energy of the signal. X of t is equal to. Find the energy of the signal. X of t is equal to e to the power of at. Find the energy of the signal x of t is equal to e to the power of at. Okay, x of t is equal to, okay, so here a can take the value greater than 0. A can take the value greater than 0. So greater than 0 means it's a positive value. Greater than 0. Then okay, now let us find out the energy of the signal here. So any doubts? My video and audio is audible. Clear clarity is there, right? Any clarity is there? To getting the clarity in the video and audio, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Okay, so thank you. So you can take the energy of the signal. So first you let us write the generalized formula. Even though your problem calculation is wrong, for the formula at least you'll get 1 marks here. So write the generalized formula. So energy is equal to integral minus infinity to plus infinity x of t magnitude of the whole square into dt. X of t magnitude of the whole square into dt. Okay, so x of t is nothing but this one e to the power of at. So it has been given, it has been defined from 0 to the infinity. So energy is equal to, so 0 to the infinity e to the power of at the whole square, e to the power of at the whole square into dt. Okay, so e to the power of at the whole square is nothing but 0 to infinity e to the power of 2at. So because you know the law of indices, okay, the formula. So a to the power of b to the power of c can be given as a to the power of b into c, we can write here b into c. So like that we have written. Okay, you know the integration of e to the power of ax, it is e to the power of ax by a. Okay, so you know the integration of e to the power of ax into dx. So this is e to the power of ax by a. Okay, so that is the integration of that one, e to the power of ax. Let us substitute here. So this is e to the power of 2at divided by 2a. The limit is from 0 to the infinity. Okay, so apply the limits here. So if you apply the limits, so it is e to the power of infinity, the upper limit is t is equal to infinity, so minus e to the power of 0, the lower limit, so divided by 2a, and you know the value of e to the power of infinity, So we know that e to the power of infinity is nothing but it's an infinity. E to the power of minus infinity is nothing but zero here. Okay, so e to the power of infinity is nothing but infinity minus e to the power of zero is one divided by 2a, divided by 2a. Okay, so infinity minus one is nothing but if you are going to add anything to the infinity or subtracting is nothing but this is equal to infinity only. So this is equal to infinity only. So therefore, the given signal x of t is not an energy signal. Is not an energy signal. It's not an energy signal. Okay, so this is the given signal is not an energy signal here. Done, right? Any doubts? Any doubts? So the given signal is not an energy signal. X of t is not an energy signal. Okay. I'll go for the next problem. Take the next problem. Find the average power of the. Find the average power of the triangular pulse. Find the average power of the triangular pulse. Find the average power of the triangular pulse x of t. Find the average power of the triangular pulse x of t shown in the figure below. Okay, so this is our triangular pulse. So if it is there means it is continuous one here. It will go to the infinity like this. Okay, so this is the time interval t. This is point one. So the magnitude is minus one. So this magnitude is nothing but one here. So here we need to find the expression for the waveform. So this is 0.2, right? Done. So this is our triangular pulse. For this one, we need to find out the average power. So you can see the waveform, right? So this is minus one. So this is plus one. Again, this is minus one. This is 0.1. This is 0.2. Okay, so here we need to find out the two expressions we need to find out here. Can by observation, can you tell me what is the fundamental period? By observation, can you tell me what is the fundamental period? By observation, can you tell me what is fundamental period?
Minus 1 to 1. Minus 1 to 1.
This is a 0.1, is it? This is 0.2, is it? So minus one and plus one are the amplitudes here. Okay, so this is amplitude. Okay, it is from 0.1 to the 0.2 here. So 0 to the 0.2 here. You can see the fundamental period is nothing but the time taken for the one complete cycle here. Complete cycle is nothing but like this, it will come here. Again, it will go, it will come like this here. Again, it will go, it will come like this. So this is the one complete cycle is this one here. Okay, so good attempt. Okay. So what you can do is the fundamental period is from this one up to this one. So it is from 0 to the 0.2 here. So fundamental period is equal to the 0.2 seconds here. So for a periodic signals by observation, we need to find out if the waveform is given, we need to find out the fundamental period like this. Or if the mathematical expression is given, like in the previous problem, we need to find out the fundamental period here. Okay, so done. So like this, we need to find out the fundamental period here. T is equal to 0.2 here. Now we need to find the expression here. So the expression of the signal can be find out in the two things here. One is from 0 to the is less than t is less than or equal to the 0.1. So 0 to the 0.1, one expression we need to find out here. Again, from the 0.1 to the 0.2, because this is rising here and this is falling here. So two new expressions we need to find out within the two time intervals here. Okay, so from 0 to the 0.1, other one is from 0.1 to the 0.2. The two expressions we need to find out here. Let us find out that one by using the two-point formula. In the last class, I explained how to find out the how to use the two-point formula and how to find out here. So by using the two-point formula, that is the two-point line formula. Okay. Two-point line formula. So we have the expression that is y minus y2 divided by y2 minus y1, x minus x2 divided by x2 minus x1. Okay, x2 minus x1. So here the y2 and y1 is nothing but y2 is the amplitude here and x2 is the corresponding time interval. X y1 is the corresponding amplitude and x1 is the corresponding time interval here. Okay, so for the first one, for the first interval, that is from 0 is less than t is less than or equal to the 0.1. So x1 is nothing but, so 0, x1 is nothing but 0. The corresponding y1 is nothing but, its amplitude is minus 1. Okay, so similarly x2 is nothing but the corresponding time interval. So it is 0.1 and the corresponding amplitude y2. So this is equal to the 1 year. The corresponding amplitude is equal to the y2 is equal to 1. This is 1 and y1 is equal to the minus 1 here. Let us substitute and find the expression here. Do it first. Substitute x1 as 0 and x2 as 0.1. Okay. And y2, y1. And you can substitute y is nothing but x of t. And x is nothing but t you can substitute at the end here. So tell me the expression. Do it fast. Can I get the answer first? X of t is equal to. Substitute x1 is equal to 0 and y1 is equal to the corresponding amplitude is minus 1 here. Y2 is equal to 1 and x2 is equal to 0.1. You can do substitute wherever the values are there. And finally, you can substitute y is equal to x of t and x is equal to t here. Can you get the answer? Can I get the answer? First, substitute. So y minus y2 is nothing but it's 1. Y2 is 1 minus of minus 1. Y1 is the minus 1 here. So x minus 0.2. 0.2 minus x1 is 0. Okay, so this implies, so 1 minus of minus 1 is nothing but 2. So 2 into x will become 2x here, cross multiply, 0.2 into y is nothing but 0.2y minus 0.2 is equal to, so 2x minus 2 into 0.2 is nothing but 0.4 will get here. So cross and minus 2, that's why it will become plus 2 here. So it is 0.2y is equal to the, so minus 2 go that side. So 2x minus 0.4 plus 0.2. So this will become 2x plus, sorry, minus 0.2. Okay, so y implies 2x minus 0.2 divided by 0.2 here. So 2 ones are 2 tens are. So this will become 10x. Next 2 ones are minus 1 here. 0.2 ones are 0.2. So this will become x of t is equal to. So 10t minus 1 will get here. 10t minus 1. Got everyone? The same answer?
Sir, x2 is 0.1 or sir?
X2 0.1, right? So sorry. Okay, x2 is 0.1, not 0.2. Yeah, 0.1. So this means that this will become, so 0.1 minus 0. So y into 0.1, this has become 0.1 into y. Okay, so this will become 0.1 here. Correct now? So this is 0.1, correct? So 0.3, is it correct? Correct, no? So 0.1 into y. So y2 is nothing but, so this y2 is nothing but 1 year. So correct. X is nothing but, x2 is 0.1 year also. So sorry, make the correction. X2 is 0.1, here also 0.1 here. Okay, so this has become 2. Okay, so this has become 0.1. Make the correction. 0.1 you will get here. So this will become 20x minus 1. 20x minus 1. So this will become 20t minus 1. The limit is from 0 is less than t is less than or equal to the 0.1 here. Okay, so I substituted x2 as a 0.2 here, but it's actually 0.1 we have taken correctly here. So wherever x2 is there, you can do substitute here. So you can do substitute. This is 0.2 plus 0.1. So this will become 0.1. So it will become, so whenever we divide here, so 20t minus 1 will get here. Then everyone, 20t minus 1. Done?
Yes, sir.
Any doubts? My voice is audible, right? Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you got the answer, right? Now we got x of t. Can you tell me the expression for another one? Can you get the expression for other one? Next one is Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, sorry, because some internet problem, it has been disconnecting. Okay, so now, okay, it's fine, it's audible, right? Yeah. The expression x of t. Anybody got the expression for x of t?
3 minus 20 t.
3 minus 20 t. So that is from point 1 is less than t is less than equal to the point 2. Okay. Sorry for the interrupt of the because of the net problem it is getting. Okay, so got a variance, got the same answer. Hearing got the same answer, right? Okay, so now let us find out the power of this one. So the power, the periodicity of this one is the average power is given by. So you can take, so 1 by t, the integral from 0 to t, you can take the limit, any limit you can take here. X of t, the magnitude of the whole square into dt. X of t, the magnitude of the whole square into dt, you can take here. This is the average power. Okay. So this is the average power of the signal here. So P is equal to the average power is nothing but 0.2. The integral from, so let us split the integral into two parts here, x of t. So I'm going to take x of t into the two parts here. So it is 20 t minus 1. The limit is from 0 is less than t is less than 0.1. And 3 minus 20 t. So it is 0.1 is less than t is less than equal to the 0.2. Okay. So just sorry, solve it neatly. X of t is equal to, so 20 t minus 1, 0 is less than t is less than or equal to the 0.1, 3 minus 20 t. So 0.1 is less than or equal to t is less than or equal to the 0.2 here. Let us split the integral into the two parts like this here. So p is equal to 1 by 2. The integral from 0 to the 0.1. So 20 t minus 1, the whole square into dt, plus the limit is from 0.1 to the 0.2. So 3 minus 20. Let's do integrate. Okay, so do integrate and find the average power here. Do integrate and I'll find the average power of the signal here. Okay, so done. We'll do right. So the average power, I'll give the answer. You try the answer here. So you can do integrate like as we did in the last class. So it is the 0.33 watts you'll get here. 0.33 watts. Okay, 0.33 watts. Okay, so done, right? Will you do it right? Okay, so take next problem. So I'll give this problem, the continuation of this problem I'll give you here. The continuation of this problem.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah, tell me.
Sir, I got the 2 minus 20 t, sir.
Which one, this one? 3, yeah. Okay. Okay, you can verify here. So you got it is a 3 minus 20 t. Let us do verify here. When t is equal to 0.1, let us substitute the lower limit here. When t is equal to 0.1, so 20 into 0.1 is the thing, but it will become 2 here. So 3 minus 2 will be the 1 we'll get here. You can do verify the answer by substituting the limits here. Okay, when you substitute t is equal to 0.1, this will become 2. So 3 minus 2 will be the 1 we'll get here. That's upper limit we are getting here. For the lower limit, when t is equal to 2, if you substitute here, so 3 minus 0.2, right? So 20 into 0.2 will become 0.4 will get here. So how much it will become? 2 into 2 will become 0.4. So this will become, okay, so you can verify the answer. So how much is the answer? 0.2. The lower limit should be equal to the 22 minus 1.